Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss hedge funds. Now a lot of students have asked me to explain the concept of hedge funds. What exactly is a hedge fund? What are the career options in a hedge fund? So first of all, will you believe that five hedge fund heads, I mean the managers of the hedge funds globally, they made more than $1 billion each last year? That is 7500 crores was the earning of a single individual from hedge funds. I mean, that is some rocking number. $12 billion. Yes, that's more than what JP Morgan Chase paid 56,000 of its investment bank employees. That's the amount which hedge fund industry earned last year. It is two times what gamblers lost in Las Vegas last year. Yes, $12 billion is what they earned. 15 hedge funds managers collectively earned in 2019 $12 billion. I mean, it's a lot of money, and there are statistics sourced by Bloomberg. So TCI fund manager management Chris John, his individual earning was $1.8 billion. Jim Simons from Renaissance Technologies, $1.73 billion. Ken Griffin from Citadel, $1.5 billion. Steve Cohen, 0.72 AMC, $1.26 billion. And Chase Coleman, Tiger Global Management, $1.1 billion. These are like mind-boggling returns. So one tends to understand, is this only an exception? Are these only five people? No. Even from rank 6 to rank 15, people have earned like the minimum is $200 million. $200 million is 1500 crores. What these people have earned. D. Shaw is a common name, Bridgewater, Lone Pine Capital, etc. So what is a hedge fund? Before that, I just wanted to talk about winning ways, because these are also winning ways of hedge funds. Earn Academy is a learning platform for chartered accountancy. So it's holding a Ranker special week, free live classes. So the episode 4 for this is with Shubham Singhal, who is AIR 4, in November 2018. And his strategy is to increase efficiency of the D-Day. So there is a session on the 13th of November at 11 a.m. where you learn how to increase your efficiency on the day just prior to the exam and the exam day. So AIR 4 CA Final November 18, Shubham Singhal is going to give a free session. I am sharing the link in the description below. And you can please watch it, because it adds a lot of value. Coming back to hedge fund, so what is a hedge fund? It's a limited partnership between a fund manager, also known as a general partner, and the investors, who are sometimes known as the limited partners. So what does the general partner do? The general partner manages the fund according to the fund strategy, and the limited partners contribute the money. That is you, me. When we become very rich, we are going to invest in hedge funds. And what is the purpose? They are going to maximize investor returns and eliminate risk. Regardless of whether a market goes high or declines, hedge funds have such strategies that they are going to make money irrespective of the market's direction. So it is very, very different from a mutual fund in terms of aggression, in terms of scale, in terms of how it borrows money to enhance capital appreciation for its investors, for its limited partners. It's a very, very different industry. There are different kinds of hedge funds. One is a long-only equities, where they only buy common stock and they don't sells short. Then private equity, which involves buying entire private businesses. So hedge fund is going to buy, let's say, an entire Indigo Airlines. It will buy it, delist it, take it over, and then improve, and then sponsor a public offering, bring it again for IPO. It's like a private equity. Then they are going to trade in junk bonds, which are high risk, high yield bonds that can go badly if you are invested in by someone who does not know what they are doing. And then specialize in real estate, where they know that they have a very clear understanding of the pricing of the market. Risk is relatively low. So long only equities, private equity, junk trade bonds, specialize in real estate, and then special asset classes such as patents and music rights. So imagine there are hedge funds. We take that kind of category that, okay, there is a special album by A.R. Rahman, which is going to be released. Let's invest in that. Amazing. So there are various kinds of hedge funds: arbitrage, relative value, bottom up, directional, fundamental, long bias, opportunistic, short buyer, systematic quant, top down macro. So for sake of brevity, I am just naming the funds. So if you want to really go into depth, you can always get into it. Which are the large funds, hedge funds in the world? Bridgewater Associates, what is their assets under management? Almost like $1 trillion. So this is like in million, right? So it is $98 billion is what they have in management. And then Renaissance Technologies, $70 billion is assets under management. My God, this is the kind of numbers BlackRock has got. This is one common name, $40 million. TCI Fund Management, $35 billion is what they have. DE Shaw, $34 billion. And this is mind-boggling in terms of numbers. So they really enjoy economies of scale. So what they should do? They are more aggressive in terms of their investment strategy so that you get a higher return. So what happens is with leverage strategy, for example, they will borrow and trade money on top of the capital gain from the investment. So for example, if you have $1 billion from your investors, you will also borrow another $1 billion. So you will make a higher gain, but maybe higher loss as well. So it is very important that a hedge fund employs complex risk management tools in terms of hedging the exposure it has so that the risk of these investments is reduced. So remember, because unlike a mutual fund, we just invest your money in the market, hedge fund will take your money and also borrow equivalent amount of money from the market so that it multiplies returns for you. In India, hedge funds are known as alternative investment funds. So you remember we had Ms. Radhika Gupta, who is currently the CEO of Edelweiss AMC. We had her on Career Conversation show here. So she was one of the pioneers of the AIF concept in India. It's a new concept of investment in India defined in Regulation 2.1 of the SEBI Regulations 2012. Category 3 AIFs are allowed to benefit from rising stocks. So they can go long on a stock. So when you go long on a stock means you predict that the stock is going to go up, or falling stocks where you short the stock. So you sell at 100 today, assuming that tomorrow it will go down to 80, and then you can buy in the market and deliver and therefore make a clean gain of 20. So there are these kind of, and they are also in India also, they can take leverage. So for example, up to twice their capital. So if AIF has a size of 100 crores, it can borrow an additional 100 crores to invest. Amazing, right? So in India, you've got category 1 AIF, which is investment in startups, SMEs and projects which are socially and economically viable. Category 2 is in debt and equity, private equity fund, debt fund, fund of funds. And then category 3 is investment at short-term returns achieved by employing complex trading strategies. So you really need to be, you know, real top-notch talent in order to have a career for yourself in a hedge fund. Or you are like a PIPE, private investment in a public equity fund. So this is courtesy Paisa Bazaar I sourced this diagram. So AIFs have a minimum ticket size of 1 crore. In terms of fees, they typically have like a 2 and 20 cost structure or a variant of the same. That means they will take a 2% annual expense and 20% will be the performance fee, that is levied on the return that they generate above a threshold. So you got a hurdle rate, let's say that if it is 15% is the threshold. Now above 15%, whatever the fund generates, let's say 5%, in that case, 1% of that additional 5%, the fund manager will keep as a performance incentive. So 2% he will charge as annual expense ratio and 1% he will charge as the performance fees. So if the fund delivers return of 12%, it can impose a return of 20% of the returns above 8%. So maybe 4% into 20% is like 0.8. So this will ensure that you will get only 11.2% because they are going to take that performance fee. All categories of AIFs except Angel Fund can have a maximum of 1,000 investors, and the ticket size is like 1 crore. You need to be a really HNI in terms of wanting to invest in an HU, hedge fund. Now, where is the career path in a hedge fund? One, you can be a research associate where you will do this investment research, where you will do the donkey's work, basically the grunt work, developing reports, making PPTs and markets and asset classes. You will understand real estate, etc. Maybe you will build financial models also depending on your experience. Now, if the research associate has no prior financial modeling experience, then the analyst or the senior analyst will help him do that. So you will also help the senior analyst write recommendation reports that is sent out to the portfolio manager. Then the research analyst is someone with 3 to 5 years of sell side or investment banking experience. The senior analyst or a sector head or a director of research is what this person is. And then you have the associate portfolio manager and then the portfolio manager. This is a key guy who makes, he's like a mutual fund manager who makes the investment decisions on behalf of the hedge fund. So this is the cream profile in a hedge fund. So the hedge fund career path or hierarchy vary from firm to firm, but a representative example is junior analyst or a research associate means he's a random task monkey. Whatever you give to him, he has to do it. Then hedge fund analyst is a number cruncher guy, the researcher. Then you've got the senior analyst who will make the investment ideas, who will collate them. And then the hedge fund portfolio manager, he's the guy who takes the decisions and he's the firm's representative. And on the execution trading side also, path is like this only junior trader or execution trader who will do the training, trade in training, and senior trader or head trader who will do more P&L responsibilities. He's responsible for the profit and loss which the hedge fund earns. So you've got this junior analyst, so you are an undergraduate at a top university, or you graduated, worked in some other industry, and then attended a top B school. So normally it's very difficult to do something truly unrelated. So then you do a MBA and then which a hedge fund offer. So that you usually need some type of investing or finance experience pre-MBA for this. So analyst 3 to 4 years after you are a junior analyst or a research associate 2 to 3 years, then you move to an analyst level 3 to 4 years, and then senior analyst or sector head 3 to 5 years, and then this is the cream thing, portfolio manager. That's where you actually want to work in a hedge fund. So very very limited opportunities in hedge fund. So one, I mean, a lot of money that they are earning, but of course this industry size is very small in terms of the team size. It is not like it's like a Tata Steel or a Aditya Birla Group or a Reliance where there are huge huge structures. Typical investment banking, typical private equity or hedge fund will have very limited number of people. They look at super super exceptionally bright people, cream de la cream. So hedge funds, you need to start as this random task monkey as a junior analyst and then move up the ranks. It's going to take some time, but it's really worth that effort if you are really very serious about investing and you think that you can make a career for yourself in hedge funds. So that's what it is in terms of I had to prescribe for you. So I hope this gives you a very good idea of hedge fund. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you find this video interesting, please share it with your near and dear. Thank you.